Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Boys. Yeah. Hola, hola. Hola, we them boys. Hola, we them boys. Hola, hola, hola. We making noise. Hola.
Bring you an interconference match here at the Quicken Loans Arena. Thanks for tuning in, everyone, to this broadcast of NBA basketball on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. You look at Sacramento.
And guys, this is an opponent that's given. Them problems first two times out that they met. Both losses. We'll see if the third time is the charm.
This is their last chance, Greg. I mean, the final game of their season series against this group. So they're looking for a measure of redemption and, of course, trying to avoid being swept.
Now Sacramento starting five. McLemore and Gay on the perimeter. DeMarcus Cousins out there with Quincy Ace. And it's Rondo in at the point. Now here's Rondo. They look to him for part of their offensive attack. Right now he averages nearly 12 points a game.
Good ball movement. He put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
And the Cavaliers with possession here. The Kings getting the bucket. Lays it in off the breakaway. Rondo's got his second basket. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. Irving attacking, and the foul called on DeMarcus Cousins. That is his first foul of the game.
Oh man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
They get it again. Out to Smith. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson.
Looked like he was trying to go for a degree of difficulty points on that shot.
Irving against Rondo. In the corner, it's McLemore. No good. And it's the Cavaliers taking it the other way. Moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
You know, I don't like to use the word shock, but that was a shocking result for me. Nobody saw that one coming. To lose to that team was surprising enough, but to get blown out like that.
I know. I mean, I'm with you there. It just seemed as though they were sleepwalking their way through that entire game. It was, in my estimation, just inexcusable.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Now, here's Irving. With an average of around 19.5 points a game, his scoring has been a constant for them. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But boy, that was a nice job.
And early on, they've been nearly perfect from the floor. Just the one miss here on their first five attempts.
Gay drives in. Good.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Greg, you're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
Irving kicks to LeBron. Here's Smith. Can't get it to go. Nice D from Cousins. For the Sacramento Kings, their last game a loss to the Rockets in Houston.
Just looking at the stat sheet, they gave far too many free throws away in that game. Maybe it was the noise in the building or something, but they really looked rattled.
Well, Greg, I don't know if it was the biggest reason for that loss, but all of those misses from the stripe clearly had an impact on that game.
Irving kicks to Thompson.
Well, he's an undersized center, but he more than makes up for it with some serious leaping ability.
Cousins with a screen on Irving. Rondo kicks to Cousins. Pass to AC. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
This guy is a high flyer. I mean, especially for a power forward, and he needs to be as an undersized player.
Here's Thompson. And the rejection by Cousins. Rondo on top. He's covered by Irving. Here's Cousins. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
And that one falls for DeMarcus Cousins. And the Cavaliers will go with a different look here. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. Amon Shumpert's checked in for Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Kyrie Irving. And the Kings will go for a different look here. Caspi, he's checked in for Quincy Ace. Bellinelli comes in for Rudy Gay. Curry's checked in for McLemore. And it's Collison in for Rajon Rondo. Screen by Cousins. The drive by Collison. And he sinks the shot coming off the strong pick.
They're really struggling defensively, giving up too many easy buckets.
Great point. Really an embarrassing performance defensively, and the coaching staff can't be happy.
Mozgov. Not enough on that one as it misses. To the wing right side. The shot by Curry, no good. It's stolen. 3 seconds left. And after just one quarter... Welcome back, everyone, to Lopsided First Quarter in the books already as we start the second quarter. And for the Kings, guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
Just the start they're looking for in this game. Solid offensively through the first.
Very crisp and sharp. Not much stagnation at all on offense.
Pulling out the wings, it's Shumpert and LeBron. Channing Frye out there with Mozgov. And it's Dellavedova in the point guard. So that's who's on the floor for the Cavaliers. Here's Bellinelli. Looking for his first basket still in this one. And Caspi kicks to Collison. 6 on the shot clock. The Kings need to get off a shot here. And Kosta Koufos picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
Boy, did he go hard to the boards, but clearly went over the back in doing it.
Yeah, kudos for the effort. I always love that kind of effort, but he was just a little overzealous.
Smith checked in for Cleveland. And the Kings also making a change. Cauley Stein's checked in. Dellavedova dishes to Fry. Kufis grabs the miss.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
To the left side wing. Cauley Stein with it. Mozgov on him. Out of bounds. Cleveland will take possession.
A temporary lapse of focus from him on that turnover. It's embarrassing, but on occasion it does happen.
Kevin Love's checked in for Mozgov. Count that one. The Sacramento lead has been cut down now to just six, and the basket from Love.
And he just big boyed it right there. The height advantage he's got down low, really difficult for them to defend.
A nice shot by Kufis.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
The Cavaliers have gone 2-3 from the field here to open the second quarter. Dellavedova, the pass to Love. In the corner, Smith with it. The dish to Dellavedova. That one goes. Count over. Dellavedova's got his first bucket of the night. Feeds it to Kufis. Here is Caspi, guarded by Shumpert. Just five on the clock. Collison kicks to Cauley Stein. To the paint. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation.
Well, Sacramento, since the All-Star break, we get a look at the numbers they've put up here. Second in steals. Seventh in assists. And they are in the top 10 in team points per game.
And going back to their steals ranking, you have to appreciate the quick hands. I mean, the ball's never safe when they're on the prowl. And I think that mentality is what bothers opponents.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Tristan Thompson, he's checked in for Fry. And Irving subbed in for Matthew Dellavedova. Smith, no luck. Kings leading now by six. Rondo kicks to Cauley Stein. And Thompson sends it back. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Thompson. Quincy Acey's checked in for the Kings. And Sacramento has possession. They've led by as much as 10. Shoots from eight. McLemore, no good.
He operates well in traffic, but still, that's just a tough play to finish.
Love outside. And another miss by Cleveland.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
I tell you what, I think he'd be happy if he can continue to get looks like that.
Here's the screen. Passes to McLemore. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. It's going to go on Tristan Thompson. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Kings.
You know, guys, we've really seen them do a lot of damage in the paint so far.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
The Cavaliers making a switch here. James has checked in. Love outside. Back to Irving. Six to shoot. The drive.
Even when they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular. And he pulled it off.
Well, maybe, yeah, maybe this is the best time to do it.
I agree. I mean, now's when you need a spark, something electric to get your teammates fired up.
And Acey kicks to Cousins. Knocked away. It's stolen by McLemore. Stolen by Thompson. That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time. As we close in on the start of the playoffs, let's see how the West is stacking up. Taking a look at Golden State. And, of course, the Kings tied up with them. Mozgov, he's checked in for Kevin Love. And the Kings also making a change. Bellinelli's checked in. Here's Rondo. He's got six to the inside. Ozdov with the steal.
Not sure if they're aware of the two-for-one opportunity.
Well, they ought to be. I mean, that basic basketball time management. You've got to be aware of your clock and your situation.
40 seconds left in the first half of the game. Irving with it. Shot clock at 5. Here's Shumpert. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now 1 for 2.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync. Tremendous communication and awareness.
1 second separate in the shot clock and game clock. And Cousins throws it down.
And a few more points tacked on to their lead in the cruelest way possible.
You're right. Yeah.
Those putback jams sting, don't they? My goodness.
Yeah, they really hurt you. I mean, the defense forces a miss and then can't rebound it and finish off the defense. They're hanging their heads in their chest now. He presents a defender with a serious check.
And that concludes the first half. Kings lead by 7. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half. And the third quarter about ready to get underway. You look at DeMarcus Cousins in this game, he has been everywhere.
It's been about his ability to just lock down the opponent from a defensive standpoint. A lot of shots also being blocked.
That reach he's shown, Greg, has certainly been fantastic in getting to some of these shots. I mean, he looks like he's got telescopic arms out there.
Now the second half about to start up and begin any moment. You look at DeMarcus Cousins in this game, he has been everywhere.
Yeah, the rebounding, particularly on the offensive side, as good as it gets. He was bringing the effort down low.
And I tell you what, that allowed him to get his team several multiple shot opportunities. His work on the offensive glass has been invaluable.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. On the court for Sacramento, McLemore and Gay on the perimeter. DeMarcus Cousins out there with Quincy Ace. And it's Rondo in the point guard position. Love outside. Here's Thompson. Second chance shot. But they'll get another chance. Out to Smith. Cleveland moving the ball around. Slammed home, and he draws the foul. A chance for another point at the free throw line. It's going to be on Rudy Gay.
And buckets like that have been hard to come by. Not the most exciting game. Both sides look way off in terms of their shooting.
And, Greg, you know how it is. Sometimes it only takes one or two baskets to get things going. Maybe we're getting ready to pump a little life into this one.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
Caspi gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. And Cleveland making a change here. Fries checked in. And then for Sacramento. Kufis comes in for DeMarcus Cousins. And Curry subbed in for McLemore.
Wow, wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
Blatant contact. Straightforward call. Simple.
Shooting for Cleveland.
The Cavaliers have made their only other free throw attempt today in an earlier trip to the line. Kings leading now by 5. Outside Collison. Outside Curry. He dishes it to Cauley Stein. Back to Curry. 5 to shoot. The drive by Collison. That went off the back iron and out. The Cavaliers have gone only 1 of 5 from the field since halftime. Very slow start offensively.
went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Hey, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
Now, here's Collison. The scoring numbers have been solid for him. He's averaging just under 14 points a game.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
For Cleveland, they have shot two of three from the free throw line tonight. Mozgov, he's checked in for Cleveland. The Kings leading. Pulls up on the elbow. Here's Cauley Stein. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Yeah, just nice strength there and then just off with the shot.
Boy, with all the contact he drew there, Greg, that would have been a heck of a bucket. He nearly got it to go.
Come on, Shumpert has checked in for James. Ellinelli, he's checked in for Sacramento. No one near him. That's good from Shumpert on the assist by Smith. It's Curry outside, and he gets it to go. Curry's got himself going there, his first points of the game in the deep ball. Here's Dellavedova. He's covered by Collison. And here's Smith. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game.
A chance here to see how the Kings rank in the NBA right now. Third in scoring, fourth in assists. And they also show up as a top five team in steals. Young, aggressive, and athletic, getting into the passing lane.
And going back to their scoring average, I think it really gives them confidence. They go into every game knowing that they're going to get buckets. A few key stops here or there, and most nights, that's all it takes.
Boy, with an open look like that, he is so gifted. Man, you've got to play better defense. Eventually, he's going to make you pay.
Yeah, you can see he's still in rhythm, even though he misses that one almost always deadly when he's that open.
Here's Cauley Stein. The Cavaliers making the shot. And they immediately answer back with the dunk at the other end.
And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, Jay. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
But it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt. But still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
Basket. To Collison. Curry dishes to Casper. The drive by Collison. That's good. And it's a 6-point Sacramento lead.
Wow, risky shot there size-wise, but the incredible skill that he possesses allows that one to go.
Well, the quick high release negated any height disadvantage he had right there.
Kings have gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. He kicks to Casper. Here's Cauley Stein. Makes it off the glass. Cauley Stein's got 7 points.
You got to love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of grinded out physical game.
That's the kind of look they can continue to go with. Maybe that'll help them create some separation on the scoreboard.
And we've reached the end of the third. It's Sacramento. We've got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. The fourth quarter of action getting started. Kings leading now by 6. LeBron and Love are the talented pair at the forward position. Irving is out there with Matthew Dellavedova. And it's Thompson in at the center. So that's who's on the floor for the Cavaliers. Here's McLemore. Good D from Love.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Wow, that's a really smooth finish.
That's why we and they always love seeing him at the end of those breaks. He makes it look fun and easy.
It's as if the defenses have just given up.
Yeah, you know, the pace has only picked up the deeper we've gotten into this game, which is remarkable. It speaks to the endurance and stamina of these teams, and it's also been a lot of fun to watch.
So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive, Greg. You know that. I mean, another good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line.
Kings leading now by four. And the official signaled the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. Quincy Acey's checked in for Costa Cupas. We played just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter. James in the post. He's covered by Gay. Somehow misses the one-handed flush. Rondo drives in, lays it up and banks it in. And the Kings lead by six.
I'm not sure who was supposed to be on him that possession. I mean, apparently, neither did the defenders.
I think he was surprised by how much space he had there and just rushed the shot a little bit.
Stolen by Thompson. Irving from long range. Here's Dellavedova. It's blocked. And it's out of bounds. The Cavaliers able to retain possession here. And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here. And on the way from Irving for three.
And you know what? He's just not on his game. No doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Out of bounds, Cleveland takes possession. The Cavaliers trail by six. Down low, here's Thompson. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Hey, guys. Well, George Karl had some advice for the team in that last huddle. His advice, clear cut. I want to see you playing to win, not playing not to lose. I don't care what the lead is. We do not back off.
J.R. Smith's checked in for the Cavaliers. Now here's McLemore. Down to five on the shot clock. Gate kicks to Cousins. And Thompson sends it back. The drive by James. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
And let's get your guys' take now on the hustle stats for the Kings.
Contested shots and block shots. They're bread and butter defensively. They're giving up no easy looks.
Yeah, but they've been offensive defensively tonight because they've really forced the issue on D and come up with quite a few steals and deflections.
That's good.
Yeah, great post position. That's going to be key here in crunch time.
Gate kicks to Cousins. Stolen by Thompson. And the jam by J.R. Smith.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Could be. A dunk like that coming off a great defensive play has to build some momentum.
Sacramento making a switch here. Collison's out there. Stolen by Collison. And Acey kicks to Cousins. And stolen by Love. Here's Irving. The Cavaliers again can't hit.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
And the pass to Gay. Now the feed to Cousins. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. And the Kings lead by one.
Big time bucket there, and you can expect to see him stay very involved the rest of the way.
Irving kicks to James. Poke loose. To the middle. Here's Cousins. And here we go. Cavaliers running again.
As clutch a shot as I have ever seen. In a word, gutsy.
Kicks it out to Gay. Wide open look. Money! What a big possession right here.
No doubt about it, guys. The tension is palpable.
7 second difference, shot and game clock. Collison, the pass to Cousins. Gay kicks to Cousins. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials on the contact, and he'll shoot two.
You had a foul to give there, but you'd rather not have it cost your team points.
I agree. I mean, you would have been better off using it on the floor and not on the shot. But the foul had to come either way, so it is what it is.
Second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a three-point game.
Those were pressure-packed free throws. And he looked as cool as he could be. So big to give them that three-point lead.
Timeout called, Cleveland. They're trailing by three. There's 14 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Cavaliers making a switch here. James dishes to Love. And McLemore kicks to Cousins. Pass to Collison. And so it's Sacramento who scraped by with the win. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for them.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And that about does it for the final game of the NBA regular season. For Clark, Greg, and Doris, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And now time to go to Ernie Johnson, who's alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
Can't be sleeping, keep on waking without the woman next to me. Guilt is burning, inside I'm hurting. This ain't a feeling I can keep. So blame it on the night. Don't blame it on me. Don't blame it on me. Blame it on the night. Don't blame it on me. Don't blame it on me. Blame it on the night.
You to know that I'm all yours. You and me, we're the same. You know where I'm